This morning in the Rhode Show kitchen, we are joined by TV maitre d' Joe Zito and Chef Andrea Nadeau from Camille's restaurant. And I know we were talking about Zeppole's and buying the Zeppole's in the bakery. We're going to do you one better. We're making Zeppole cupcakes, and I think I'm pronouncing it wrong.
Yeah, no, this is the Rhode Island translation. Zeppole. More than one is Zeppole's.
Okay.
And this is how we do it. But no matter what you say, they're delicious. And of course, then there's my favorite Italian rock band. You know who they are?
No.
Did you ever hear of Led Zeppole? They're fantastic. I'm telling you right now, I got all the music.
You got them all.
All right, what do we got going here?
Yeah, Andrea, tell us, first of all, we're making Zeppole's into a cupcake.
Into
how are we going to do that?
Well, first of all, I have to credit my friend Bridget. She came up with the idea. She just texted me and she said, hey, do you make Zeppole's? I said, no, not really, I don't fry them, but we could do cupcakes. So
nice idea, Bridget.
Infused all the flavors of a Zeppole into a cupcake.
Beautiful.
So it's a basic butter cake recipe that I gave you guys to post online.
We will do that.
And what I did is I added ricotta cheese to it and a little rum. So it's a little more dense and it has more flavor.
Sure.
Nice.
And then we made a traditional Italian pastry cream and I added candied cherries, real candied cherries, not maraschino cherries, and candied orange peel.
Beautiful.
And a little bit of vanilla. And you make a traditional pastry cream, let it set up, and you hollow out your cupcakes and you fill them with the pastry cream just like a Zeppole.
Nice. And the other ingredients on here that we'll need to make that
super
filling?
Easy. We have half and half. We have, or you can use milk, vanilla beans, flour, sugar, salt, and the candied fruit, and 6 egg yolks.
See?
A lot of simple stuff. There you go. Okay. And they're perfect size for kids or if you want 6 of them yourself.
Absolutely,
which is
about going to happen in about 2 minutes.
Exactly. We'll show you how they're made coming up in a little bit. Back to you. That's next.
But for now, back to the kitchen. Will?
We're
oh my God.
Really?
Oh,
never mind. We're explaining to Joe. It's not National Pea Day.
I can't have my glasses on. Oh, please. All right, listen, I want to let the viewers know I want them to know if you see black smoke billowing out of the Rhode Show kitchen chimney, it means that Chef Andrea, it's a signal that Chef Andrea burned the Zeppole cupcake.
No, she's not going to burn the
Zeppole.
She's not going to burn it.
Are you going to do your job? You want me to do this?
You know, we may have to switch places.
I know.
All right, what are we going to do right now?
Okay, I already have the cream and the vanilla in the pot steeping to get the beans out of the pods, and I'm adding the candied orange in just to infuse the flavor into the cream. Here we have 6 yolks that I just started to break up a little bit. And we're adding 2 cups of sugar.
Okay.
And we're going to just
whisk
it in until it turns a little light in color. Because you want to kind of change the molecular structure of the sugar so it's not gritty and it bonds to the egg.
Okay.
So it's nice and smooth.
It has to have a smooth consistency.
Yes, because the next thing we're going to do is add the flour in, and you don't want any lumps. Nobody wants lumpy pastry cream.
No. Only into pancakes.
Yep, and you can use a KitchenAid to do this. I just didn't want to pull it out because it's too loud to work with.
Okay.
So it's a little bit lighter in color. If I had more time, I'd keep going.
Right, no lumps.
It was pale, but there are no lumps.
No lumps.
And then we're going to add sifted flour. The most important thing.
All right, so we got to sift it first, or can you buy it sifted?
No, you have to sift it first.
God.
Can't
Nick
buy it sifted.
Very complicated.
They do so many things for you, but not sifting your flour.
All right.
But that avoids like the lumpy gravy.
Right.
Same concept.
So put that all together.
Mix it in.
And the consistency's got to be the same. No lumps from the flour or anything else.
No lumps. You want it perfectly smooth.
Okay.
Okay. And once the flour is all incorporated, we're going to temper the eggs with a little bit of the warm cream.
Now, does this have to go in
slowly?
Slowly, right?
Just a little bit. Okay. You don't want to cook the eggs and curdle them.
Okay.
And you're going to stir it together.
White smoke there.
Yeah, there is white smoke. We have a pot.
White smoke's good.
White smoke is good. All right, we're going to keep whisking away. It's National Pie Day, not Pie Day. We're going to put everything together. We're going to make Zeppole's cupcakes, all good stuff. Back to you.
I'm going to sift.
Back in the Rhode Show kitchen this morning, and
eat the bits.
We have got a
snack 10 times this morning.
You're rushing it. They're not finished yet.
No, but
Chef Andrea from Camille's and TV maitre d' Joe Zito are going to make Zeppole cupcakes.
Yes.
I'm excited for this take. So last we saw, we were just whisking away.
Okay, so the pastry cream is finished. What you need to do now is to put a piece of plastic wrap right on the surface of it and refrigerate it till it's ice cold.
Okay.
And it'll be nice and thick. And I already had some I made and put into a piping bag.
Beautiful.
So before we pipe that, I just want to show
you. Cherries in there too.
Yep, I added cherries into that batch. This is an apple core. It makes life nice and easy.
Yeah.
You just put it down halfway, not all the way, and give it a little twist. And you pull out the center.
That's right, because we're going to be filling these with the mixture that we made. Is that right? So twist.
Yep. And just comes right out. And then these are the snacks for Josito.
There you go. Here you go, Joe. Yeah. While I'm continuing to
do this. And you've heard rotten to the core, and yes, associated with me many times.
Perfect for you. No, while we're I'm scooping these out, talk about what you have there.
Well.
And I'll fill these.
There is reason to celebrate in Italy, is there not? Yesterday we have a new pope. That's wonderful news.
You're right.
So they're celebrating at the Vatican in Rome. Mm-hmm. And Tuesday, St. Joseph's Day. And we've got Zeppole Cupcakes. Well, if you want to have a little celebratory thing, let's go and stay Italian. This is Prosecco.
Yum.
This is the Italian version of champagne. Mm-hmm. Prosecco has a sweet little sister. That's called Asti Spumanti.
Okay.
But this is Brut. This is Mianetto. You'll see their name. They're one of the most popular Italian Proseccos in the United States. They make many, many different varietals. Mm-hmm. This is a $13 bottle. It's wonderful, it's crisp, it's clean, it's light, it goes
perfect
with anything.
Celebrating.
And it's fantastic. And I just think it's reason to celebrate. Mm-hmm. Tuesday's reason to celebrate. San Giuseppe. So it's all good.
And after St. Patty's Day and cupcakes too, we're going to be celebrating Easter and Camille's. You guys are open, Camille's is
open for Easter Sunday dinner. You can call for reservations noon to 5. It's a beautiful place to celebrate Buona Pasqua, as we say. And I wanted to let the viewers know that there's also, Chef Andrea does this baking. It's her own business,
they
and it's called
awesome.
Carina Dolce, you. And you can find that on Facebook.
You can, and it'll actually be an actual spot come 2014.
Really? Congratulations.
Breaking news here on the Rhode Show.
Pop that open, we got to celebrate.
Exactly.
So talk a little bit about what you've done here. Sorry, you were piping, so went into the filling and then also on the top.
I just piped and brought it up a little bit, depends on how much filling you want. Mm-hmm. And then I added a candy cherry. These are not maraschino cherries. They're actually real cherries that have been candied.
I like that.
You can probably find them at Whole Foods or the grocery store.
Okay.
And then just dust with a little powdered sugar, so they resemble more of the traditional Zeppole.
Oh, no, finally, I'm going to get to eat one of these, okay?
Yeah, now go ahead. I won't smack you away
from this
one.
No, this is for you.
Yeah, you just have to be patient sometimes, Joe.
That's for you. And I love the containers that you've decided to bake them in. I mean, look at that. When I'm undoing it, you can see it.
These are
holds together so well.
A company called Le Petit Gâteau, and you can buy them. They're all different prints. I just chose these for
adorable.
The Easter holiday.
What do you
say, Joe? Cheers.
Cheers.
That's happening right now.
Very delicious, isn't it?
That's a good breakfast snack.
It is a good breakfast snack, or a lunch snack, or a dinner snack, or a dessert. Or
and as I said before, they're small, so no
timer.
Guilt.
I would love a napkin.
That's what I do here.
I have
ballet.
Towels.
I'll take that. You know, I'll take anything. I got some frosting on the side of my face. This is perfect, and I think it's great, too, if you have kids at home, they can help with this one because it's very simple, very easy. Is that right?
Yes, and that's, as I said earlier, if you don't want to follow the recipe for the cake, you can use a standard white cake box mix and just add a little bit of flavoring to it to make it resemble the flavor of a Zeppole as well. So you don't have to go through all the trouble. And the pastry cream really took a few minutes. You can even use vanilla pudding and hook that up, too.
Yeah, it does kind of have a pudding texture. It's so nice and cold, and I really like the combination
of the key
to frosting.
Now, do you like Led Zeppole, too?
Sure do. All the time. You and your jokes today, Joe.
No, pretty good.
All right, so we do have the cake recipe on our website. You did send that over to us. And, of course, the filling is on our website as well. So enjoy your Zeppole cupcakes. If you want them, head to WPRI.com.
Thank you.
Looks good to me.